This is the application for the Birdbuddy Smart Brid Feeder. Right here, you can see this is the landing page that we come into. However, if you see this icon right there, that is a little bird. If we swipe that down, we have two different sets of notification. Here we have, you've had some visitors while you were away and we spotted them. Or you've got this one up here. It's been busy at your feeder. See who's here. Tap on either of those will bring you into the Birdbuddy app and land you on this page right here. Now I have left these icons up because, well, these are indications that you have had birds at your feeder. Now I've let this go for a couple days now to kind of show you just how cluttered this area can get. But what we're gonna do is I'm gonna open up a couple of these, kind of give you an idea of what the animation looks like and what you can expect to see when you get told, hey, there was a bird at your feeder. So we're gonna open this one up right here. You get a little animation. You get a look who we caught, total number of sightings, gives you an estimate as to what the bird actually is. In this case, it is a common grackle. And then I can select collect or more options. In this case, for this bird, I'm going to select collect. What that will do is then bring me into a myriad of pictures that this took, or they're called postcards. So I can either say, this is a common grackle because it's not sure, the AI is not sure that this is a common grackle, or it gives me a listing of, hey, it might be some of these other birds based on what we think. I can also come all the way down here to the bottom and say none of the above, and then I can search for what I think the bird is, or I can ask a Birdbuddy expert as to what this bird is, and then generally you'll get a turnaround between 2 to 3 days. I can also select to save this visitor as a mystery visitor, meaning they'll add them to a mystery collection, or I can ignore this visitor. And there are times that you're probably going to want to ignore visitors. Like if you get sparrows all the time and you've collected hundreds of them, maybe you don't want to this time. In my case, I'm going to say, yes, this is a common grackle, and add to collection. Here, we have a video that is taken of my common grackle. I can select yes and save this video, or I can select no thanks. I'm going to select save. From here, it's going to show me those images or stills, and I'll have to swipe left or right to save. Save. Nice one. All right, that's kind of a duplicate. I swipe that way, it doesn't get saved. That one, he's mean mugging me. And there we go. Now I have collated my collection of birds. Now I have a choice. Do I share this with the community and save, or do I share privately? Well, with my common grackle, I'm going to select share with my community. And then it brings me to the next tab over. I'm going to come back to my main tab with all of my birds, and we're going to do another one. But here we have a common grackle again. So I'm going to select down here, more options. This will bring me to that collating page that I was talking about before. In this case, I'm going to say, ignore this visitor. And this is what happens. It's going to let you know, hey, this is going to be ignored. And then it's kind of like, hey, they all can't be supermodels. And I'm going to select continue. Now, none of those grackle pictures that were wrapped up in there will be added to either my private collection or the public collection. The one problem with this, and I found the Birdbuddy tends to do, is it will group birds together. The grackles were very busy, but if there were other birds in here, so if I hit collect, maybe there was another bird. There's a video. I can say save or no thanks. In this case, I'm going to say no thanks to the video this time. Swipe grackle, and there we go. And this time I'll save privately. So these will not be added to a community page that other people can see. This time we'll hear a noise because I turn the sound on. Drum roll, boom. Here we go. House sparrow. I say collect. You hear it. Sound. Here's a video of the house sparrow. I'm going to say no thanks. I got lots of videos of them. No, it's not a great picture, so go that way. Got a lot of pictures of them. Oh, I didn't save any pictures this time. So I can say, let's have another look. Go back and grab pictures if I want to use them. Or I say, no thanks, delete this batch. Drum roll, and you're done. So hit continue, and that goes away. Here is the last picture that I have saved, so we're just going to open that up. Why not? Drum roll. Here's a North American cardinal. I'm going to select collect this image. Here's a nice video of it. I know this is a common one that hangs out around here because it's missing a little portion of its foot there. And that's something you'll get with Birdbuddy. You'll kind of get used to the birds that are around you. And this is a great way to keep track of them. So I will save that to my community and come back one more time to the front of the page, because here, if you send a bird off to be identified, I knew who this was, but I sent it to be identified to see how quickly it would turn around. Well, once it's identified, you get this notification right here saying mystery is solved, and I select reveal my visitor, and it lets me know this was a North American cardinal. And I will collect, and I can share or save privately. I will save privately. And there we go. So that's everything that we can do on this main page. The main page, once you've sorted through everything, will be a timeline of all the birds that have visited. If I come to this middle tab here, this is our collections. This is going to be the collection of birds that the camera has seen. You can sort by either bird or time of visit. And you can see all the birds that have come to my feeder. You also have indications of new, when a new bird has been spotted. And we're gonna come down and pick, scrolling down, here's a collation of my mystery visitors. So if I tap on that, it will open up, hey, these are things that I wasn't sure about. Or here it was two birds in one, so the camera wasn't sure what to identify as. And then kind of gives you stats. Coming back, I'm going to pick this guy right here. This is a ruby crown kinglet, at least I hope, because the AI is a little off depending on lighting and how the bird actually poses itself. So right here, we've got the picture that my camera took. Scrolling down, you can see there is a gallery for this, but if we come down here, you have more information about this bird. You have, hey, it's an expert songster. Clicking this gives you a little more information. Hey, it's also a loudmouth, more information, and a daredevil, more information. And it gives extra stuff here, number of visits, favorite foods, some other general information, and then do you want to hear this bird? Now, if we come back up to the top and select gallery, I will have the ability to look at my gallery for this particular bird. And here you can see it's two different birds because you can see right there, it kind of looks like a different bird than this was. And that's because the AI is not 100% all the time. But this will show you my gallery. And from here, I can select information about this bird, or I can select share and then share this however I like. Now I'm going to select back. And then notice at the top, I could select community. Now the community will show you all the other people who have shared their picture of this bird. And the community is a nice feature, but you can kind of see, hey, this actually looks like the bird, a ruby crowned kinglet. Mine, not so much, unless that's the female version. I don't know. I'm not as familiar with bird watching. That's why you get this. So just know, as long as you're okay with identifications being a little off, and if you come into the community gallery, there might be a mixture of birds in there, depending on if people said, no, that's not the right bird. So hypothetically, if I come here to this chickadee and go to the gallery, well, for the most part, I know these are a chickadee, but if I come over to the community, well, maybe there's a couple other birds in here that aren't chickadees. And this probably wasn't a great example because it looks like all of them are, but you get the idea. Community, good feature, but might have a mix of actual birds. Scrolling down, just to give you an idea, little things about information, just so you see, they're different for each bird, as well as visits do go up, their favorite foods, how big they are. And then for this one, you have songs and calls, and you can find me here. It lets you know the region that you can find it. And then all the way down here, a gallery for that bird. So that's what you can do here under the collections tab. Coming over to the right, we have our settings. This is going to be the settings for your particular Birdbuddy. You can tap on that to change your name, email, or password. Here we have information about my particular Birdbuddy. It is currently ready for birds, meaning it's not at night and gone to sleep. And I have 95% battery. If you have the solar roof, you'll see a little charging symbol around that when it's actively charging. It's going to show me the name of the Birdbuddy up at the top. It's going to show me the signal strength of the Wi-Fi, the battery percent, and then what I'm covering up is the actual location. Moving that out of the way, we actually have the ability to test a live stream. So if we're setting this up, we simply tap on that and realize it might take a little bit of time for this to wake up the camera on the other end, because it does stay in sleep mode most of the time to preserve battery. And we'll just let that run really quick. And right here, this is a live view from my feeder. This is on Android, so iOS might look a little different and allow you to do different features. From here at the top, we can close our live stream. You can see that it says, hey, while you're doing this live view, postcards aren't available. And then we can close from here. So I'm going to close the live stream. We have the option to go off grid, meaning that it turns off the Wi-Fi module and just becomes a, hey, take pictures. Selecting go off grid, as you can see here, kind of puts it on break. It will not send out any postcards. So make sure, unless you're going away for a long period of time and can't refill or change the battery, that you don't mess with that. You have the ability to add a member. So if somebody else, Birdbuddy account, you can share your individual feeder. You tap on that, a unique code is generated, and then you can share that with somebody else. Here you have your serial number, and then check for updates. And that was all under our Birdbuddy up there. Here we have add a Birdbuddy. So if this is your first time adding a Birdbuddy to your account, this is how you would do that. You have account settings right here, which will allow you to change your password or username. Application settings, turn on and off your sound, turn on and off the watermark, and then what language do you want, as well as notifications. I personally keep the app sound off because the drum roll, while impressive the first time, gets a little redundant, especially if you have to go through a lot of different images. Selecting back, we have help and support, assembly instructions, privacy policies, and terms of use. All the way down at the bottom, we have buy a Birdbuddy if you want to buy more, and then log out. And realistically, that is everything that you can do with the Birdbuddy app for the Birdbuddy Smart Brid Feeder.